Hey there! Welcome to The Young Gods, your one-stop destination for all things entertainment, pop culture, and video games. Join us as we dive into the world of movies, TV shows, and gaming, exploring hidden gems, iconic moments, and the latest trends. From in-depth analysis and reviews to fun trivia and behind-the-scenes facts, we've got you covered. Before we begin our countdown of the top 10 stoner comedies, let's take a moment to acknowledge some exceptional worlds that, while not making it to our list, certainly deserve a special mention. 1. Ted 2012 is a hilarious movie about a man and his talking teddy bear who smokes weed, drinks beer, and gets into trouble with his girlfriend, his boss, and a creepy stalker. 2. Jay and Silent Bob Strike Back 2001 is a hilarious movie about two stoner friends who travel across the country to stop a film adaptation of their comic book characters, encountering various celebrities, fanboys, and enemies along the way. 3. Grandma's Boy, 2006, is a comedy about a video game tester who moves in with his grandmother and her two elderly friends and gets into hilarious situations with his coworkers, his boss, and his rival. To discover more, make sure to stay tuned until the end of our top 10 list. Today, we have a special treat for you, the top 10 stoner comedies that you can't miss. If you love to laugh while high, subscribe now and become a part of our passionate community. Number 10, Cheech and Chong's Up in Smoke. At number 10, we find Cheech and Chong's Up in Smoke, the film that catapulted the iconic stoner duo to fame. They hilariously lampoon hippie culture, cruising in a pot-made van, rocking out, and dodging the law. Released in 1978, it proved a box office sensation, earning $44 million from its $2 million budget. It has some unforgettable moments like the Dave's Not Here bit and the Let's Make a Dope Deal game show. Number 9, Friday. This comedy classic, set in South Central Los Angeles, follows a day in the lives of two friends as they grapple with a bully, indulge in marijuana from a dealer's supply, and clash with neighbors. F. Gary Gray made his directorial debut with this 1995 release, featuring Ice Cube and Chris Tucker as the laid-back duo. Craig and Smokey are indebted to drug dealer Big Worm. The film struck gold, earning a whopping $28 million in box office revenue against a $3.5 million budget. Number 8. Pineapple Express. This is a stoner action comedy that combines weed and violence in a hilarious way. The movie follows a pot-smoking process server and his dealer who witness a murder and go on the run from a corrupt cop and a drug lord. This was released in 2008, and it was produced by Judd Apatow. The movie was inspired by a strain of marijuana called Pineapple Express, which is very rare and potent, and was a success at the box office, grossing over $101 million on a budget of $27 million. Number 7. Easy Rider. This is a landmark of the counterculture movement, with two bikers who travel across America in search of freedom and adventure. The movie explores the themes of rebellion, alienation, and drug use, and it also has stunning cinematography and a rockin' soundtrack. It was released in 1969, and it was nominated for 2 Oscars. However, this movie was made on a low budget of $400,000, and it grossed over $60 million worldwide. Number 6. The Big Lebowski. This cult classic, released in 1998 and directed by the Coen brothers, centers on the dude, a laid-back stoner mistakenly identified as a millionaire. Filled with memorable quotes, eccentric characters, and absurd scenarios like bowling, nihilists, and a rug that ties the room together, it initially flopped at the box office, grossing just $17 million against a $15 million budget. Nevertheless, it has since amassed a devoted following, securing its place among the greatest comedies of all time. Number 5. This is the End. Halfway through the list, at number 5, we have This is the End. This is a meta-comedy that features many celebrities playing exaggerated versions of themselves during the apocalypse. The movie is full of self-deprecating jokes, outrageous scenarios, and hilarious cameos, such as Emma Watson, Channing Tatum, and the Backstreet Boys. It was released in 2013 and was directed by Seth Rogen and Evan Goldberg. This hilarious comedy was a hit at the box office, grossing over $126 million on a budget of $32 million. Number 4. Superbad. This modern twist on the high school comedy genre features two inseparable friends on a mission to secure alcohol and female attention for their graduation bash. Packed with both crude and clever humor, it blends these elements with a touching message on friendship and maturation, produced by Judd Apatow. This 2007 release draws from the genuine escapades of its teenage scriptwriters Seth Rogen and Evan Goldberg. Remarkably, the film earned over $169 million at the box office, all while keeping its production budget modest at $20 million. Number 3, Dazed and Confused. This is a classic portrayal of the 1970s high school life, with a focus on the last day of school. The movie has an excellent ensemble cast and a killer soundtrack, and it showcases the various aspects of the stoner culture, such as cruising, partying, and getting high. The movie was released in 1993, and it was directed by Richard Linklater. The film achieved a humble triumph, raking in $8 million while costing $6.9 million to make. However, the movie gained a cult following over the years and is now considered one of the best coming-of-age movies of all time. Number 2. Half-Baked. This is one of Dave Chappelle's best movies ever, as he plays a janitor who finds a pound of quality bud and decides to sell it with his friends to bail out their friend who accidentally killed a police horse. The movie features many funny scenes and characters, such as Sir Smoke-a-Lot, Samson Simpson, and Bob Saget. This was released in 1998, and it was co-written by Dave Chappelle and Neil Brennan. The movie was not very successful at the box office, grossing only $17.5 million on a budget of $8 million. However, the movie became a cult classic among stoners and comedy fans. Number 1. Harold and Kumar Go to White Castle. And finally, the number 1 spot goes to Harold and Kumar Go to White Castle. This is the ultimate stoner comedy that follows the adventures of two stoner friends who crave White Castle burgers after smoking some weed. The movie also has some clever jokes about race, sexuality, and politics. It was released in 2004, and it was directed by Danny Liner. The movie was a surprise hit at the box office, grossing over $23 million on a budget of $9 million. So, these are my top 10 stoner comedies that you can't miss if you want to have a good laugh while high. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more content like this. And don't forget to hit that notification bell so you never miss an episode.